Hi guys, it's that time of year again where we have gatherings and game playing. Today I'm sharing with you guys this really fun game. Now it's known by a few names. Some call it the lump of coal game, some call it the plastic wrap game. Some people call it the saran ball game, so up to you. I call it a whole lot of fun. What I like to do around the holidays is hit all those sales. So a lot of times they're 75% off the day after Christmas. Sometimes, some years, it comes before Christmas. So pick up a bunch of things, especially gift boxes and gift items that come multiples in a package. That way you're getting a ton of items for less than a dollar a piece. Now I like to hit up places like Dollar General and Dollar Tree and Walmart, places where I know I'm gonna get a great deal on a bunch of items that are totally random, but will make someone smile, laugh, and that anyone would enjoy. I love to include things like candy, pens, socks, funny little toys from the kids section, and gum. Now you can always hit Dollar Tree and get some saran wrap, or you can do what I did and buy it in bulk from Walmart. You're also gonna need two pair of oven mitts and some dice that I picked up at the Dollar Tree. Now what I like to do is have a grand prize. That's the first thing you're gonna wrap and the last thing to come out of the ball, and I like to include a little cash. So this is a little cup I picked up from the Dollar Tree that I'm putting a 20 in and starting to wrap the ball with my clear wrap. Now again, you can get your clear wrap from anywhere. I just wanted to buy it sort of in large amounts since I am making two balls for two parties. Now, since all of the toys were 75% off after Christmas last year, I did pick up this huge tub of slime that gave it a good weight right at the center. So I just put the top right on. Now, my son helped me in perfecting this, and I will tell you, it took us a little trial and error. We figured out the easiest way to wrap these would actually be gripping the box of cellophane with your feet and then using the force to pull up and wrap it. He also discovered that throwing in a few little twists in between items really made the game a whole lot of fun because it kind of complicated the unwrapping process. Now, I know a lot of people like to wrap their pieces individually, and what you do is you actually have to unwrap the item once you have gotten it out of this large cellophane ball before you can pass it on to the next person, which will slow down the game. Now, we didn't do that. But if you would like to make the naughty list, what you can do is go ahead and cut the cellophane at random points throughout the wrapping process, which makes it a whole lot more difficult to find the new starting point in the cellophane. Now you can see he just twisted the cellophane, and that really helps secure items. Now we used hot sauce because we got something like 7 bottles for $3. And if you want to use glass, just be careful. It didn't break on us, but I would hate to ruin your party by having you have broken glass with tons of hot sauce all over the place. So keep that in mind when you're picking out your items. Stick with things that are not going to be breakable and would be liked by a range of people, from children to older adults. Now you can use as much cellophane as you want. It is the most expensive part of the game. I did find a ton of stuff on clearance, and I'm telling you, I spent hardly anything, and we had all of these items to wrap up. So just keep that in mind. The most expensive part will actually be the clear wrap. Now here's a look at the two that we made. We made one for a young adults party and then one for a mixed group that we were having at our house for New Year's Eve. And they are hunka big and hunka heavy. So much fun. Totally random things, from cheese to candy, hot sauce, socks, nail polish, you name it, it's in there. And sometimes the sillier the gift for the person, the funnier the game is. Now this game can get a little aggressive depending on how competitive you are. Here's a look at a group playing at our house. So what you do is the person ahead of the person with the ball has a little plastic container with two dice. You have to roll doubles before you can pass the dice to the next person and get the plastic ball. Now you also have to wear these oven mitts. My boys kind of perfected this by standing up and using gravity, but they are so competitive. It was so much fun, especially when they would get to one end of the plastic wrap and had to find the new beginning. This is a whole lot of fun for all ages. If you've ever played it or have a variation, comment down below, and I'll see you back very soon.